Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. We are studying accounting for partnership firms from TS Grewal for class 12th. We have reached chapter 2, accounting for partnership firms, the fundamentals, and at present we are discussing the past adjustments, that is the adjustment for incorrect appropriation in the past. We have reached question number 70. I hope you have gone through my previous videos in which we have solved the previous questions. In past adjustment, some of the provisions given in the partnership deed is not attended or not given to the partners, like interest on capital, interest on drawing, salary to partners, commission to partners, and the books of the firm are closed. But after the books have been closed, we will rectify those errors by passing an adjustment journal entry. That is what is past adjustment. Now let us see question number 70. Manu and Srishti are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 3:2. Following information is of the firm as on 31st of March 2020. Here is the balance sheet given. In the liability side, capitals of both the partners are given, and on the asset side, drawings and other assets are given. Now, in this question, drawings are not transferred to capital account. Drawings are shown separately as debit balance in the asset side. So while calculating the opening capital balance of the partners, these drawings will not be taken into consideration. Profit for the year ended 31st March 2020 was Rs 50,000, which was divided in the agreed ratio. But interest at the rate of 5% per annum on capital and 6% per annum on drawings was inadvertently omitted. Adjust interest on drawings on an average basis for 6 months. Give the adjustment entry. Now, interest on capital is not given to partners and interest on drawings has not been received from them. So this is the adjustments which we have to make. For this, we will have to calculate the opening capital balance of the firm, because interest on capital is to be calculated on the opening capital balances, not on the closing. And the balance sheet given in the previous page is on 31st of March 2020. From there, we will calculate opening capital balances on 1st of April 2019. And at the same time, interest on drawings is not received from the partners. We have not charged interest on drawings from the partners. So these are the two adjustments which we have to see and make an adjustment entry. Now for solution, first we will prepare the partner's capital account by balance brought down. That is the opening balance which we are looking for. This will be ultimately calculated. And profit for the year is also given by profit and loss account, appropriation account. It is 50,000. Net profit for the year is 50,000, which is given to the partners in the ratio 3:2 without providing for interest on capital and interest on drawing. So 30,000 he has received and 20,000 Srishti has received. Drawings we will not show here on the debit side, because it is separately maintained as debit balances and therefore shown in the asset side. So straightforward, to balance close down. As given in the balance sheet, it is 3 lakh for Mannu and 1 lakh for Srishti. Now, if we subtract this, here we will get the opening balance. It will be 2,70,000. 3 lakh minus 2 lakh 7 minus 30,000 will give us 2,70,000. And 1 lakh minus 20,000 will give us 80,000. Now, after calculation of opening capital balances, we will go for adjustment table, in which we will see that what misappropriations have been made. So first let us see what appropriation of profit was expected under correct distribution. Correct distribution, interest on capital. Interest on capital, Mannu's capital is 2,70,000. On this we have to charge 5%. So Mannu was supposed to receive an interest on capital 13,500, and Srishti 80,000 her capital balance, opening balance. On this 5%, it will give us 4,000 rupees. Now, interest on capital is paid by the firm to the partners, but interest on drawing is received by the firm from the partners. So interest on drawings we will subtract. Interest on drawings, their drawings are as given in the balance sheet, 40,000 for Mannu, and rate of interest on drawing is 6%. But only for 6 months, because the question asks to calculate interest on drawing only for 6 months. That is 1200. And Srishti's drawings are rupees 20,000. On this also 6% for 6 months, it will be 600. If we subtract these two, here the firm has to pay 13,500 to Mannu and receive 1200. So how much actually the firm should pay to the partner was 12,300 for Mannu and 3,400 for Srishti. If we total these two amount, it is an error of 15,700 out of the total capital 50,000. Now this 15,700 has wrongly been distributed to the partners in their profit sharing ratio 3:2. So let us calculate wrong distribution. This 15,700 is distributed in the ratio 3:2. So Mannu had already received 9,420, and Srishti had received 6,280. So if we compare these two figures, we will get the difference in amount. I mean to say that Mannu was supposed to receive 12,300 correctly, but under wrong distribution he has received 9,420. Therefore the firm should award him 2,880 rupees more. Whereas Srishti has already received rupees 6,280, but actually Srishti was supposed to receive 3,400. So the firm has to take back rupees 2,880 from Srishti. So it is a minus figure here, because 3,400 minus 6,280 will give us minus 2,880. So the minus amount will be debited and a positive amount will be credited. So the adjustment entry will be Srishti's capital account debited to Mannu's capital account. We will pass this rectifying journal entry through capital account, because Capital account of partners are fluctuating. It is not fixed. Because when the question is silent about fixed capital account or fluctuating capital account, then we should consider that the capital accounts are fluctuating. So we will pass the journal entry here. Srishti's capital account debited to Manu's capital account. 2880. Being adjustment entry passed. And date we can write 1420. So this is the solution. Now let us see the next question. Question number 71. Mudit, Sudhir and Uday are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:1:1. Their fixed capital balances are rupees 4 lakh, rupees 1,60,000 and rupees 1,20,000 respectively. Net profit for the year ended 31st March 2018 distributed among the partners was rupees 1 lakh without taking into account the following adjustments: interest on capital at the rate of 2.5% per annum, salary to Mudit rupees 18,000 per annum and commission to Uday rupees 12,000. Mudit was allowed a commission of 6% of divisible profit after charging such commission. Pass a rectifying journal entry in the books of the firm. Show workings clearly. Now in this question, the capital accounts are fixed, so the adjustment entry will be passed through opening a current account of the partners. And these are the capital balances on which we have to allow interest on capital. We need not to calculate opening capital balances because capital account is fixed. And much calculations for commission to Mudit is to be done because 6% of the divisible profit after such commission is to be calculated first. So let us see the solution. Now let us see the solution. First we will see the correct distribution. Correct distribution is the distribution of that portion of profit which is written in partnership deed. And the firm has failed to provide that points to the partners. So first is interest on capital. Interest on capital. Now their capital accounts are fixed. So on their respective capitals, we will give them, the firm will give at the rate of 2.5% per annum. So Mudit is having a capital of 4 lakh. On 4 lakh, 2.5% is 10,000. Sudhir is having a capital of rupees 1,60,000. 1,60,000 into 2.5 divided by 100 will be 4,000. And Uday's capital is 1,20,000, 2.5% of which is rupees 3,000. Total is 17,000. Now salary. It is said that salary of rupees 18,000 is to be paid to Mudit. Now commission. There are two commissions. First commission of rupees 12,000 is to be paid to Uday, 12,000. And second commission is also there, which is to be calculated on the divisible profit. The question says that Mudit was allowed a commission of 6% of divisible profit after charging such commission. So far the expenses are 47,000 and the profit is 1 lakh. But this is net profit. This is not divisible profit. Divisible profit will be achieved after subtracting 47,000 and also the commission which we are trying to calculate, Mudit's commission. So this is 53,000. This 53,000 comprises both the divisible profit and Mudit's commission. So we will break it into commission and divisible profit. How? 53,000 commission will be 6% as given in the question, but this 53,000 is both divisible profit and commission. If divisible profit is 100%, then commission has to be 6% of divisible profit. It means that 53,000 is 106% of the divisible profit. So we will break it like this. So here we will get a commission of rupees 3,000. So total of 50,000 has been misappropriated by neglecting the items given in the partnership deed. So this is our correct distribution. Now we will compare this with wrong distribution. 31,000 Mudit is supposed to receive, and 4,000 Sudhir would have received, and 15,000 Uday. But as per wrong distribution, this 50,000 rupees has been wrongly divided among the partners, ignoring all these points in their profit sharing ratio 1:3:1:1. It means Mudit has received 30,000, Sudhir has already received 10,000, and Uday has also received 10,000. So we will compare these two amounts by subtracting each other. Mudit was supposed to receive 31,000 and he has already received 30,000. So 1,000 we will give him more. Then 4,000 Sudhir was supposed to receive, but by mistake he has received rupees 10,000. So we will take back 6,000 from him. And Uday was supposed to receive 15,000, whereas as per wrong distribution he has received only rupees 10,000. So 5,000 will be more awarded to him. So positive means credit and negative means debit. So the adjusting journal entry will be Sudhir's current account debited. Sudhir's current account debited rupees 6,000 to Mudit's current account rupees 1,000 and to Uday's current account rupees 5,000. Why are we making the entry adjustment entry through current account? Because it is given in the question that partner's capital account is fixed. So we will pass the journal entry. Sudhir's current account debited rupees 6,000 to Mudit's current account. And to Uday's current account. Mudit 1,000 and Uday 5,000 being adjustment entry passed. So this is the solution. Now let us see the next question. Question number 72. A, B and C are partners in a firm. Net profit of the firm for the year ended 31st March 2020 is rupees 30,000, which has been distributed among the partners in their agreed ratio of 3:1:1. It is noticed on 10th April 2020 that the under mentioned transactions were not passed through the books of accounts of the firm for the year ended 31st March 2020. Point A, interest on capital at the rate of 6% per annum, the capital of A, B and C being rupees 50,000, 40,000 and 30,000 respectively. Here the date of capital balance is not given. It means it is on 31st of March 2020. Okay. Now point B, interest on drawings already calculated and given here. for A rupees 350, B rupees 250 and C rupees 150. Point C, partner's salary to A rupees 5000 to B rupees 7500. And point D, commission due to A for some special transaction rupees 3000. You are required to pass a journal entry which will not affect profit and loss account of the firm and rectify the position of partners inter se. Now let us see the solution. First we will see the correct distribution as per partnership deed, that how much A, B and C should receive correctly. First, in the form of interest on capital. Capital of A is rupees 50,000. 50,000's 6% will be 3,000. And B's capital is 40,000, 6% of which is 2,400. And C's capital is rupees 30,000. 30,000's 6% is rupees 1,800. So total 7,200. Now salary. As given in the question, 5,000 salary for A and 7,500 salary for B. No salary for C. So total 12,500. Then commission. Commission of rupees 3000 to A, none for B and C. Now we will grand total it here. It is 11,000 total for A, 9,900 for B and 1,800 for C. Total is 22,700. Add it this way or this way. Now these are the expenses which the firm has to pay to the partners. But the firm also has to receive interest on drawing from partners, that we will subtract interest on drawings. It is given in the question calculated. So we need not to calculate, only 350 for A, 250 for B and 150 rupees for C. Total of 750. Now if we subtract this, we will get 10,650 to be paid to A and 9,650 to B and 1,650 to C. So there is a total error of 21,950. We have distributed, the firm has distributed a sum of rupees 21,950 out of total net profit in their profit sharing ratio. Rather, it was supposed to be distributed under various heads as given in the partnership deed. So what is the wrong distribution we will compare? Wrong distribution says this rupees 21,950 paid to partners in the ratio, profit sharing ratio, that is 3:1:1. So A had already received 13,170, B 4,390, we are breaking this in this ratio, and C again 4,390. So this is how the rupees 21,950 had already been paid to the partners. Now if we compare what they actually should receive and they what they actually had received, we will get the amount which is to be debited or credited. It means A has received rupees 2,520 extra, because A was supposed to receive 10,650 and had received 13,170. So we will take back. So it is a minus figure because 13,000 is heavier than the 10,000. So minus means account to be debited. For B, B was supposed to receive rupees 9,650 and had received lesser. How much less? 5,260. So credit. And here C was supposed to receive 1,650 and had received 4,390. So we will take back rupees 2740 from him. As a result, debited. So what journal entry will we pass? What journal entry will we pass? A's capital account debited rupees 2520. C's capital account also debited rupees 2740 to B's capital account rupees 5260. So let us put it in journal. A's capital account debited and C's capital account also debited to B's capital account. A is 2520, then 2740, and for B it is 5260. Being adjustment entry passed. Now date of rectification is 10th of April 2020 because this error was rectified on 10th of April as given in the question. So this is the solution. Now let us see question number 73. On 31st March 2018, the balance in the capital accounts of Abhir, Bobby and Vineet after making adjustments for profits and drawings were Rs. 8 lakh, Rs. 6 lakh and Rs. 4 lakh respectively. Subsequently, it was discovered that interest on capital and interest on drawings had been omitted. The partners were entitled to interest on capital at the rate of 10% per annum and were to be charged interest on drawings at the rate of 6% per annum. The drawings during the year were Abhir rupees 20,000 drawn at the end of each month, Bobby rupees 50,000 drawn at the beginning of every half year, and Vineet rupees 1 lakh withdrawn on 31st of October 2017. The net profit for the year ended 31st March 2018 was rupees 1,50,000. The profit sharing ratio was 2:2:1. Pass necessary adjusting entry for the above adjustment in the books of the firm. Also show your workings clearly. Now in this question, the capital balances are closing capital balances and therefore we will find out the opening capital balances as interest on capital is to be allowed on opening capital balance. Then interest on drawings. See, Abhir has withdrawn rupees 20,000 at the end of each month. So average period, we will multiply it with average period at the end of every month, means all 12 months on the last day of every month. Bobby has withdrawn 50,000 rupees twice. First drawings were on 1st of April and second drawing is on 1st of October. At the beginning of every half year. So twice he has drawn 50,000. So it is 1 lakh. And Vineet has withdrawn rupees 1 lakh on 31st of October. So he has withdrawn this amount only for 5 months. And profit sharing ratio is 2:2:1. So let us see the solution. So solution for question number 73. First, we will calculate the opening capital balances of all the three partners. So by balance brought down. So we have to calculate this, find out the opening capital balance by net profit transferred from profit and loss appropriation account. It is 1,50,000 given in the ratio 2:2:1. 1,50,000 has been distributed in the ratio 2:2:1. So 60,000, 60,000 and 30,000. And drawings, two drawings. Drawings are rupees 2,40,000 for Abhir because 20,000 rupees per month he has withdrawn, and Bobby has withdrawn rupees 50,000 twice on the beginning of every half year. So 1 lakh for Bobby and 1 lakh for Vineet also. To balance close down, it is given 8 lakh, 6 lakh and 4 lakh. ₹10,40,000 minus 60,000 will give us 9,80,000 as the opening balance. Then 7 lakh here. 7 lakh minus 60,000 will give us 6,40,000. And 5 lakh minus 30,000 will give us 4,70,000. So these are our capital balances. On these opening capital balances, we will calculate interest on capital at the rate of 10% per annum. So first we will see, find out what is the correct allocation of profit, correct distribution. Correct distribution, interest on capital, on capital at the rate of 10% per annum. So on 9,80,000, 10% is 98,000. 6,40,000, 10% is 64,000. And 4,70,000, 10% is 47,000. If we add this, we will get 2,09,000. Now we will subtract interest on drawings. Now all the three partners are having different drawings, so let us calculate it in working note. So for Abir has withdrawn rupees 20,000 per month for 12 months at the rate of 6% per annum, and Abir has withdrawn this 20,000 at the end of every month. So average period will be 5.5 divided by 12. So it will be rupees 6,600. This average period we have already discussed in the section calculation of interest on drawings. Then for Bobby has withdrawn rupees 50,000 first on the 1st April 2017. 50,000 for the whole year at the rate of 6% into 12 by 12 for whole year, because from 1st of April to 31st of March next year, so it is 3,000. And then on 1st of October 2017, another 50,000 is withdrawn at the rate of 6%, 6 months from October to March, it will be 1,500. Put together it is 4,500. Then Vineet has withdrawn 1 lakh rupees at the rate of 6% for 5 months, on which date? On 31st 10 17 he has withdrawn. So from October end, so November, December, January, February and March, 5 months. So we will get 2,500. So we will subtract it here, 6,600. Then 4,500. Then 2,500. When we subtract it, ₹13,600 is the grand total here. When we subtract it, you will get ₹91,400 for Abir, ₹59,500 for Bobby, and ₹44,500 for Vineet. And if you subtract here also, you will get 1,95,400. Now, this is the amount allocation of which has gone wrong. Correct distribution was such, means Abir would have received this much, Bobby 59,500 and Vineet rupees 44,500. But it has been allocated wrongly. So what is the wrong distribution? Wrong distribution is 1,95,400 distributed in the ratio 2:2:1. This is the profit sharing ratio. So if you break 195,400 in the ratio 2:2:1, then Abhir has already received 78,160. So has Bobby. And Vineet has received 39,080. So when we subtract it, when we compare what they have actually received and what they were supposed to receive, we come to know that Abir has received rupees 13,240 less. So his capital account will be credited. And Bobby has received rupees 18,660 more. See, he was supposed to receive rupees 59,500. And wrongly he has received 78,160. So we will take back, the firm will take back a sum of rupees 18,660 from Bobby, and therefore his capital account will be debited. This figure is in minus. And Vineet was supposed to receive 44,500 and has wrongly received 39,080. So he should receive 5,420 more. So his account will be credited. So for this we will pass journal entry, Bobby's capital account debited 18,660 to Abhir's capital account 13,240 and to Vineet's capital account 5,420. The journal entry is Bobby's capital account debited rupees 18,660 to Abhir's capital account rupees 13,240 and to Vineet rupees 5,420. Being adjustment entry passed. That's the solution. Now let us solve the next question. Question number 74. On 31st of March 2014, the balances in capital accounts of Saroj, Mahinder and Umar, after making adjustments for profits and drawings etc., were rupees 80,000, rupees 60,000 and rupees 40,000 respectively. Subsequently, it was discovered that the interest on capital and drawings has been omitted. The profit for the year ended 31st March 2014 was 80,000. During the year, Saroj and Mahinder each withdrew a sum of rupees 24,000 in equal installment in the end of each month, and Umar withdrew rupees 36,000. The interest on drawings was to be charged at the rate of 5% per annum, and interest on capital was to be allowed at rate of 10% per annum. The profit sharing ratio among partners was 4:3:1. Showing your working clearly, pass the necessary rectifying entry. So in this question, the capital balances are the closing balances. Therefore, we will have to find out the opening capital balances to calculate interest on capital at the rate of 10%. And profit for the year rupees 80,000 is wrongly distributed. Entire profit has been distributed in the ratio 4:3:1. Regarding drawings, this 24,000 has been withdrawn by Saroj and Mahinder in equal installment in the end of each month. Means 2000 rupees per month. At the end of every month they have withdrawn. 2000 into 12 is 24,000. And Umar has withdrawn rupees 36,000. And the date of Umar's drawings is not given. So interest on drawings for Umar will be calculated at an average for 6 months. And here the average period will be 5.5 months because at the end of every month he has withdrawn. So let us see the solution. First we will calculate the opening capital balance of the partner. So by balance brought down, this we will find out by profit and loss appropriation account. Here profit for the year is 80,000, which has been distributed in the ratio 4:3:1. So 40,000, 30,000 and 10,000 for Umar. Drawings are also given in the question. So two drawings. The capital account is fluctuating because nothing has been said about current account. And drawings are rupees 24,000 each for Mahinder and Saroj. It means 2,000 rupees per month and 36,000 for Umar. To balance close down, it is 80,000 for Saroj, 60,000 for Mahinder and 40,000 Umar. Now if we balance this, we will get the opening balance of capital accounts. Here it will be 1,04,000, 84,000 and 76,000. If we subtract 40,000 from 1,04,000, we will get 64,000 for Saroj's opening capital. And for Mahinder, 84,000 minus 30,000, we will get 54,000. And Umar's 76,000 minus 10,000, we will get opening capital 66,000 for Umar. So here we get the opening balances. Now what we have to do is to compare the correct distribution with the wrong distribution. So let us calculate the correct distribution first. Correct distribution first is interest on capital at the rate of 10% per annum. So on 64,000, 10% is 6,400. 54,000 10% is 5,400. And 66,000 10% is 6,600. Now we will subtract interest on drawings. Interest on drawings. Because interest on capital is to be paid by the firm to the partners and interest on drawing is to be received from the partners by the firm. So for Saroj and Mahinder, we are having 24,000. 24,000 and rate of drawing is interest is 5% and average period is 5.5 months. So we will get rupees 550 each. 550, 550. And for Umar has withdrawn rupees 36,000 at the rate of 5% for 6 months because the date of drawings is not given. So if we calculate this, we will get his interest on drawing as 900. Now if we subtract these two, the amount is 5,850. 4,850 and 5,700. 5,700. Grand total of this is 16,400. So there is a misallocation of 16,400 in profit sharing ratio, which was supposed to be 5,850 for Saroj, 4,850 for Mahinder and 5,700 for Umar. So we will compare it with wrong distribution. wrong distribution. In this wrong distribution, 16,400 is divided in the ratio 4:3:1. So if we break it in this ratio, we will get we have already paid 8,200 to Saroj, 6,150 to Mahinder, and 2,050 to Umar. Now if we compare these two amounts, we will get the amount to be added to the capital account or withdrawn from the capital account, subtracted. So Saroj has already received 8,200, whereas she was supposed to receive 5,850. So we will take back rupees 2,350. This minus figure, therefore it is to be debited. Here Mahinder was supposed to receive 4,850 and he has already received 6,150. So 1,300 we will take back from Mahinder. So again debited. It is a minus figure. And for Umar, he was supposed to receive 5,700 correctly, but by wrong distribution he has received 2,050. So 3,650 he has to receive more. So that will, his account will be credited. So his capital account, now the adjustment journal entry we will pass. Saroj's capital account debited. Debited rupees 2,350. Mahinder's capital account also debited. Rupees 1,300 to Umar capital account. It is 3,650 being adjustment entry passed. So this is the solution. I hope you are studying well. You are understanding the concepts. If you are having any doubt, you can comment and I will answer your doubts. Please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thank you so much for watching.